Hello everybody. As a conscious organization, we believe that we should be connecting with you again on the updates of COVID-19 at this stage. So here are the views of the chairperson of the Health Committee of the Bengal Chamber, Dr. Robin Chakraborty, who is also a renowned cardiologist. He will guide us on the guidelines for asymptomatic patients, patients with comorbidities, what are the symptoms we should be identifying to connect with our doctors, and what may be done if hospitalization is not possible. Over to Dr. Robin Chakraborty, Chairperson, Health Committee, the Bengal Chamber.
Hello everybody, I am Dr. Robin Chakraborty, Chairperson, Health Committee of the Bengal Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Kolkata. As we all know, COVID epidemic is still prevailing amongst us in the entire world. It is a real distress for the entire society. In this context, number of questions and queries came to our Health Committee. As a chairperson, I thought it may be appropriate and prudent for me to address these questions. These are, to what extent an asymptomatic person or mildly symptomatic COVID positive person should remain in isolation? The answer to this question is that the person who is COVID positive but asymptomatic or mildly symptomatic may remain in isolation and should remain in isolation, but he or she should remain in total isolation. Means there should be a separate toilet, a separate bed, separate utensils, and there should not be mix up of him or her with other members of the same house. They should not sit together and watch TV. They should not sit together and have lunch and dinner. So there has to be complete and total isolation. There is other questions like how the comorbid conditions along with COVID-19 positive, they should be tackled if they're asymptomatic. Well, this is a different question. For example, the comorbidity is a very vast term and it means a lot of things. For example, there could be associated hypertension, diabetes, heart disease, cancer, kidney disease. There are multiple types of comorbidities. For example, someone who is having just hypertension or a very stable heart disease. On the top of that, he is COVID-19 positive but asymptomatic or mildly symptomatic. He can remain at home in isolation, there is no problem. But somebody, for example, with cancer or advanced kidney disease or for example heart failure, if he or she is COVID-19 positive, then they need special attention. I will not recommend for them to remain in isolation at home. They should be either in a satellite center or in safe home. As we all know that safe home is basically organized by government and satellite centers are by the private organization, where there is a attendance by a doctor at least twice a day, plus there are healthcare workers, they visit these people on a regular basis. So advanced comorbid conditions like kidney disease, heart failure, cancer or other advanced COPD, these patients need special attention. They should not remain in complete isolation at home. On the other hand, just having hypertension or having controlled diabetes, controlled heart disease, they can remain at home if they are asymptomatic or mildly symptomatic with COVID-19 positive. But remember, medications of these disease or these illness, for example, hypertension, diabetes, heart disease, must be taken in full dose with proper consultation of the physician. Coming back to other question, that how safe it is for a person to remain at home if the patient is symptomatic. Again, it depends upon the age of the patient. There are two conditions where even a mildly symptomatic patient can be dangerous if the person is at advanced age beyond 65 years of age or having a significant comorbid condition. The question comes that there's a challenge that they may not get a bed in the hospital in a crisis situation. My advice would be, if you suspect that you have fever, you have dry cough, you have loss of taste and smell sensation or shortness of breath, and you have a history of contact with a COVID-19 positive person, then immediately get in touch with a hospital or with any center who deal with COVID-19 positive patients and try to remain in touch with them at least you can move yourself to a safe home or a satellite center, because that will help you to get a bed in case of crisis, rather than staying completely at home, assuming that you will remain well. Remember, with advanced age, with advanced comorbid condition, the chances of having complication from COVID-19 is high. Although COVID-19, large number of patients, 80% of the patients, they remain well. They do not get into a critical problem. The critical problem happens only about 5 to 14% of population. But in advanced age or in advanced comorbid condition like untreated diabetes, heart failure, cancer disease, kidney disease, patients on dialysis, or having chronic obstructive airway disease with active chest infection, you are really prone to have complication out of COVID-19 infection. So remember that. And finally, what is the protocol of testing? Well, as of now, every citizen does not require testing. Testing has been indicated for this group of patients. One, those patients who are symptomatic, having fever, dry cough, loss of taste and smell, and shortness of breath. So if there is a high index of suspicion of COVID-19, you definitely need testing for COVID-19. Second is those people who came in contact with known patients of COVID-19. So naturally, you require testing to know that whether or not you are also COVID-19 positive. Third group is healthcare workers. Those healthcare workers who came in contact with COVID-19 patients, or who are looking after those patients or those COVID-19 patients in the ward or in the OPD or in any hospital or nursing home. So healthcare workers are at high risk of having COVID-19 positivity, so they require testing. And fourth is migrant laborers. Migrant laborers, once they come to a new place, they might have got the infection from somewhere else, they need to be tested. So these are the indications as of now. Remember, COVID-19 has created a pandemic in the world, but we have to remember that 80 to 85% of people affected by COVID-19 come out clean from this disease process. Critical patients are less than 5%, maybe 3.5 to 4%. 14%, they may get severe illness called syndrome of acute respiratory illness. Otherwise, a large number of patients remain either asymptomatic or mildly symptomatic and eventually come out well out of this problem. Nothing to become panicky, do not worry, only maintain some basic protocol, wear a mask properly, and maintain sanitization, wash your hands with soap as frequently as possible. Ensure that your hands do not touch your face, nose and eyes regularly. And maintain social distance. Try to avoid public gatherings like cinema hall, theater halls, shopping malls, as well as public meeting and social functions or public vehicles. Try to stay safe, stay away from people as much as possible. And if you maintain some basic protocol, I'm sure that you will remain well. Nothing to become panicky. Have mental strength and feel that this pandemic will disappear. Maybe in next few months' time, world will be back to its normal function. Thank you very much.